Way Akip Jilly Doc. Hello and welcome to the beautiful RAF Eastland Community Center, the Community Credit Union Arena, for this afternoon's game for this weekend's tournament. It is the Nova Scotia Under 15 Major Provincial Hockey Championship Tournament. The top seven teams in the league have advanced to this tournament, and we'll give you more of a rundown of what all is going to be happening over the next 4 days after our pregame introductions. And before we get any further into our pregame, we should mention that the RAF Eastland Community Center, the entire community of Truro, and the entire region covered by the Nova Scotia Under 15 Major Hockey League, which includes all of Nova Scotia from one end to the other, all lie within the ancestral unceded territory of Mi'kma'ki. As was mentioned, our first game features the Gulls and the Bedford Bandits. Gulls finished the regular season in top spot with an incredible record of 32-1. They outscored their opponents in those 33 games by an incredible amount of 143 goals, scoring 190, giving up just 47. Bandits finished in sixth with 52 points in 33 games. They lost their series to the Novas, but were able to advance as the highest-ranked non-winning team, as the Truro Bearcats also won their way in, as we are underway here, and the Gulls score just 18 seconds into the game. Daniel Walters puts his team out in front just 18 seconds in. We talked about how potent this Gulls offense was, scoring 190 goals in the regular season. That was 25 more than the next highest. They only gave up 47. That was 34 better than the next lowest amount of goals given up. Gulls heavily favored in this tournament, and we see why, with Daniel Walter scoring the first goal of the tournament just 18 seconds in. Chip and Hartland get the assists on that goal. So once again, it's Daniel Walters' first goal, first point of the tournament, assisted by Aaron Chip and Jacob Hartland at 18 seconds. Looking at your starting goaltenders for the Gulls, it is Chandler Bell. Bell, through the regular season, had a record of 14-1, a 1.13 goals against average, a 933 save percentage, five of his 14 wins coming by way of the shutout. For the Bedford Bandits, their goaltender is Tucker Potter. He finished with a record of 4-12, a 3.88 goals against average, and an 866 save percentage. Puck is dropped down inside the Bedford zone, won by Gibbs. He'll fire it around the boards. That should be and will be an icing. 1 minute gone here in the opening frame. Our second game of the day, as we start to take you through the schedule, will be the Novas taking on the New Scotland Storm. Then the John L. Jim Cougars will play Halifax at 4 o'clock. At 5:45, we'll have the opening ceremonies, and then at 6 o'clock, the host Truro Bearcats will play their first game, and it'll be against these Bedford Bandits, who will be playing their second. Each team plays four games throughout the course of today, tomorrow, and early Saturday. And then the top four teams advance to semifinals. The winners of those two games play in the championship game. The losers of those two games will play for the bronze medal. Chip dumps the puck in for the Gulls. Henry will pick it up off the end boards. Henry with the pass over to Kidd. Kidd returns it to Henry. Now Henry gets it up to Elaine, who deflects it down the ice. Coming out of the net to settle the puck there is Bell. It's Poplinski who will fire it around the boards to Amaro. Amaro gets it set up for Power, who will bring it in across the blue line of Bedford. Fires a shot. That goes wide. Stepping up to get to the puck there is Gregoire. It ends up going in behind the net. Now Poplinski jumps in from his point, takes a shot. That goes off the leg of Breen and ends up in behind the net. Puck comes back to the line. Poplinski with another shot. That one kicked aside by Potter. Power in the corner. Works the puck up the boards. Poplinski fires a shot. That goes into the end glass. It'll come all the way up the wall to Gregoire. He'll play it down into the corner for Power. Power trying to set it up there for McDonald. It comes to the line instead. Gregoire with the shot. The save made, but the puck falls. And Power couldn't quite get a stick on it to jump on that rebound and get a second chance opportunity. Puck cleared down the ice. It'll once again be an icing with 2:36 gone here in the opening period. Format for the games will be the same as it is through the regular season. Two 15-minute periods separated by just a quick stoppage and change of ends. And then a full flood after the second period and then a 20-minute third period. So games are 50 minutes in regulation. And for the purposes of tournament play, if I remember correctly from previous years, as we're going to get our first penalty of the game, and it's going to go against the Gulls for tripping. Turner, who ended up getting his stick in the feet of, I believe it was McGilvery. And as Roberts touches the puck, we'll get the first power play of the afternoon, with Turner going off for that trip. Time of the penalty, 2 minutes, 57 seconds. I'm just going to double check on the games that end regulation in ties. I'm pretty sure from last year that if a game ended in a tie, it stayed tied. Unlike during the regular season where you would have overtime and or shootout. There's Gibbs with the puck. Gibbs' shot gets deflected up over the glass out of play. So the Bedford Bandits with the first power play of the game. And the first shot taken on the power play gets deflected up over the glass and out of play. Alain will now take the faceoff against Hartland. Puck ends up on the stick of Brocklehurst. He'll take it towards the line. Now work his way down the left wing. Fires a shot. Save made. And Chandler Bell will hang on for a faceoff there. 1:36 left to go in the power play. 11:39 remaining here in the first period. This time it's going to be Quay McDonald taking the draw against Alain. Right off of the faceoff, there was a chance for McQueen. And that gets steered aside and cleared down the length of the ice. Back to pick up is Gibbs. Gibbs comes out from behind the net. Coughs the puck up to McQueen. McQueen's got Fleming coming up to join him. There's a shot and a save. and Potter able to pounce on the puck and make sure there's no second chance opportunity there for the Gulls. 1:18 left to go in the penalty as the Bandits gotten a couple of shots away, but the Gulls end up getting a faceoff in the offensive zone. Normor can't maintain the puck. Power puts it off the side of the net, picks up his own rebound. Fighting behind the net, trying to kill a little bit of time. Now it's cleared away by McGilvery. He'll get it ahead to Hodder. Hodder plays it to Johnson. And Johnson will start to work his way up the ice. Here comes Johnson. Doesn't see a nice entry lane, so circles back. Now plays it across to Hodder. Hodder will get it back to Johnson. Johnson takes the puck down into the left wing corner. Trying to get away from the check of Poplinski. Loses control of the puck. It's played to the line, held in by McGilvery. He'll play it across to the far side for Normor. Normor gets it to Hodder, back to McGilvery. McGilvery's shot goes off the stick of Power and ends up behind the net. And it's rung around the boards. McGilvery will step up to it. Play it back down the wall. Gregoire gets to it there. He takes a hit from Cherrett. Puck gets to the line, held in by McGilvery. He's able to play it over to Hodder. Hodder steps in, gets a shot away, save, and the rebound cleared away from the front of the net by Gregoire. McGilvery back on it. 10 seconds left to go in the penalty. Johnson can't get his pass through Gregoire, and Power will clear it down the ice, and that should pretty much do it for the man advantage for the Bedford Bandits here, as stepping back out onto the ice is Turner. Pass ahead for McLean, meanwhile. Turner ends up knocking it off of McLean's stick. Hartland had it for a second, gave it to Walters, gives right back to Hartland. Hartland steps in, gets a shot away. That goes into the end glass. Chip now plays it down into the corner. Alain will be the first one to it, fires it around the boards, held in at the line there by Jay. He sends it around. It comes all the way up the near side. Foot will take it down into the corner. Centering pass gets deflected away, and out come the Bedford Bandits. With the puck here is Caden Cherrett. Cherrett working down the right side, loses the puck to Chip. Chip gets past Alain but can't get past McLean, but then with a second effort does get the puck down the ice, looking to go far side with it to Hartland, but the pass a little too far in front of him. Hartland trying to center it for Walters. That pass was deflected, and Alain will pick up and start to lead the Bedford Bandits out, but it's turned over in neutral ice. Chip coming in, gets the shot away, and Potter with a big save on the partial breakaway there. 9 minutes left to go here, first period. Alain will play it around to the far side. Robert steps up to the puck at the half wall, plays it down into the corner for Turner. Turner sends it back up the boards. It's intercepted, but then the clearing pass is intercepted right back by Liver, and his shot, Potter gloves down and hangs on for a faceoff with 8:47 left to go in the first period. We do like to try and be a little bit interactive here on Penner Sports and Streaming Services through AO Live, Atlantic Hockey Online. You can reach us through Twitter at @PetterPC_sports. That's PETTERPC_sports, as in my last name, Michael Petter. You can also reach us through Petter Sports and Streaming on Facebook. Johnson with the puck. He feeds it to Brocklehurst. Brocklehurst has it get a little too far in front of him, and the puck is kicked away by Bell. Brocklehurst picks it back up again, plays it over to Normore. Now back to the near side point, Green. His pass for Hodder goes off the heel of his stick. Normore steps up to it. Down into the corner, plays it behind the net intended for Johnson, but there to break that up was Turner. And now the Gulls will get the puck flipped out to center ice. Sonier going after it. Normore will get there just ahead of him. And Normore picks up for the Bandits, plays it ahead, and sends it down the ice. Roberts back to pick up for the Gulls. O'Leary in for checking. Roberts able to get away from O'Leary. Now gets the lead pass ahead for Walters. He scored the only goal of the game so far. Whoops. Let's do this. There we go. Now it shows up on your scoreboard. In the event that there's a discrepancy between the score that we all know to be the truth and what's showing up on your scoreboard, it's just because I haven't hit the button yet. There's a hit by Walters, who, as mentioned, was the game's only goal scorer so far. It happened back at the 18-second mark. Chip plays the puck down to Hartland. Hartland will send it around the boards. Now it's back in behind the net to Hartland after Walters returned it to him. Now looking back door for Walters, but there tying him up enough was Gibbs to not allow Walters to get a shot away. Hartland with a shot there, and that's steered aside by Potter. Puck held by Roberts. He's trying to work himself some space to get away from Gibbs. Puck played the line and down the ice. Icing gets waved off. Hustling back to get onto the puck for the Gulls is Gregoire. He plays it back up the boards to Roberts. Roberts returns it to Gregoire near side. Ahead intended for Fleming. That's knocked down by Lincoln. He'll dump it back down into the goal zone. Roberts back to get it. He plays it around to Amaro. That's knocked down by Brocklehurst. Or McGilvery, excuse me. It was 15, not 14. My apologies. With the puck now is McQueen. McQueen gets bumped off the puck by McDonald, and it's picked up by the Gulls and taken out to center. Fleming having trouble getting the puck to sit for him as it was bouncing a little bit. Now McDonald goes to dump it in. That ends up hitting the linesperson, and the Gulls have to go back deep into their own zone. 6 minutes plus left to go here in the first period. Fleming trying to work his way through. Lost the puck for a moment. Got it back. Now throws it to the front of the net. Nobody in white there to pick up. And it's going to be Carver getting it out down the ice. And that puck will miss the net. And so be an icing call against the Bedford Barons, or Bandits. That's twice I've done it now. They changed their name prior to this season. And yes, and I need to have, instead of a swear jar, I'm going to call it the bandit jar, or the baron jar. Every time I call them the barons, I have to put a quarter in. The only problem is it would be so full of quarters by the end of the weekend that it would become a weight hazard up here. Liver gets the puck out for Saunier. Saunier's shot gets deflected, goes into the end glass, and now the Bandits, there we go, got it right, are able to work their way up. Cherrett sends the puck down into the corner. McQueen takes a stab at it. McQueen will get it back at the half wall, play it back to the line, but that's going to hop over the stick of Breen, and Breen has to go all the way back down into his own zone. Just over 5 minutes left to go here, first period. Breen plays it around, comes all the way up the boards to Elaine at the line. He plays it back to Breen, but Breen has it get a little too far from him. Normore pushes it ahead, and it's intercepted there by Turner. Turner able to play it for Liver, who deflects it down into the Bedford zone. Back to get it, Breen. Johnson coming back to help as well, but Breen will play it around to the far side. Normore will get to it just ahead of Walters. But Walters helped to disrupt that puck enough, and with the assistance from Hartland, kept it in. Now it'll be cleared down the ice, and another icing call against the Bandits with 4:42 left to go here in the first period. Once again, every single game from this tournament, all 14 round robin games, as well as both semifinals, the bronze medal and the gold medal games, all available here through Atlantic Online Hockey, or Atlantic Hockey Online, which is a division of AO Live, and the production being done by Petter Sports and Streaming. A whole bunch of people involved in the process here. I have to send a big shout out to my awesome cameraman, Lucas, who's going to be working the vast majority of the games with me this weekend. As they battle along the near side wall, Hartland tries to get the puck down. It ends up coming back to Gregoire. He'll fire a shot. Might have been going wide, but Potter not taking any chances. Gloves it down anyway, and allows his team to get their defensive zone coverage reset with 4:09 left to go here in the opening period. Turner in to take the faceoff against McQueen. McQueen wins it down into the corner. Now the puck poked ahead, McQueen back on it. It's played out to center ice, dumped right back in again by Jay. McGilvery now comes near side with it for Carver. Carver gets it ahead to McQueen. McQueen, though, loses it to Saunier. Liver will pick up the loose puck. McQueen able to get it back from him as Link bumped him off of the puck just outside the blue line. Now McGilvery on it, far side, plays it around, comes up the wall to Carver. His pass into the feet of McQueen, knocked back into the zone by Foot. Now Link will get it out to center. That one knocked down by Jay. And now a hit at center ice took Potter out of the play for a moment. And now we're going to get the puck cleared down the ice. No icing. Jay with it in the far corner. picking up is Breen. He'll get it ahead for Carver. Carver's pass across ice was broken up, and Saunier now in a race for the puck with Breen. Saunier gets there first, gets a shot away. Save made by Potter. And the rebound cleared away from the front of the net by McQueen. Poplinski looking to get on the puck. He couldn't. It comes out to Saunier at center ice. He'll dump it back in. Breen will gather it up there in his own zone, ahead for Alain. It hops past him, and Gregoire will gather it in just inside his own zone. But then the puck knocked off the stick of Gregoire by Alain. He heads to the corner with it, tries to get to the front of the net for O'Leary. O'Leary gets it there. But the puck steered aside by Bell. Another shot, another save made by Bell. Now Normore with a shot. That goes off the outside of the net. Comes up to Breen. Fleming able to knock it away from him. Now a bump there between Gregoire and his man. Broken stick down on the ice. Power will pick up the puck. And Power comes out, working his way down the left wing side. Sends the puck, or takes the puck behind the net. Tried to get it out to McDonald. Following up, though, was Roberts. His shot was blocked. Now Fleming with it at the near wall. Fleming sends the puck back down low. Normore without a stick out there. Don't know why he didn't go off on a change, as the broken stick is down in the Bedford end, or in the Gull's end, excuse me. Here's McLean with the puck. He'll clear it down the ice. And that'll be an icing call. And so Normore, or right, in the U15 level, they can still make a line change off of an icing. 1:40 left to go here in the first period. Gulls leading it by a score of 1-0 off the goal by Daniel Walters at 18 seconds of the opening frame. Speaking of Walters, there he is taking the draw against Conlon. Puck goes down into the corner. Gibbs, Conlon in there as well. Gibbs plays it up to the line. Foot holds it in. Foot holds it in a second time. Now Chip gives it back to Foot. Back to Chip. There's a shot that goes just wide. Chip didn't miss by much with that one. Now in the corner, puck played up to the line. Roberts gets it down to Walters. Walters works it down into the corner. Henry is in there, as is Conlon for the Bandits. But Chip gets the puck, plays it to the front of the net. Nobody there except Charrett. Charrett not able to clear the zone, however, as it's knocked down by Foot. Now played to the near side, comes to the front of the net. Chip turns and shoots, and that just misses the far post. Conlon getting to the puck. Comes out to center. Getting on it is Hartland. Hartland trying to get away from Conlon. Henry in there as well. Puck played around to the far corner. Walters will set it to Chip. Chip trying to get it out for Hartland, but that's intercepted by Charrett, and Charrett working his way up the left wing. Fires a shot that goes wide. Puck comes up the right wing side. McGilvery holds it in at the right point. And now it's played back out to center. Charrett on it. He'll get it over to Brocklehurst. And Brocklehurst brings it back in. Under 20 seconds left to go in the period. There's a shot. Save made by Bell. And the rebound will be cleared out down the ice. 10 seconds left to go in the opening period. Pass intercepted by Turner. Turner with a shot. And didn't get quite as much on that as I think he had hoped to. And we will run out of time before the Bandits have a chance to get one last shot away. Shots on goal in the period favor the Gulls 12-5. But the only scoring comes 18 seconds into the period, as it was Daniel Walters getting his first goal, first point of the tournament, assisted by Aaron Chip and Jacob Hartland. So after 15 minutes of play, it is Gulls 1, Bandits 0. And it's just going to be a quick minute or two of a break, and then we'll have the change of ends and the start of period number 2. This game number 1 of 18 over the weekend. And Petter Sports and Streaming, working with Atlantic Hockey Online, AO Live. Very proud to be here to be bringing you all of these games. And one of the last games of the round robin on Saturday morning will actually be my 1,000th broadcast. So that's going to be kind of special as well. The game involving the Halifax Wolverines and against the New Scotland Storm will be game number 1,000. So it's been a long time coming getting to this milestone, and Kind of excited to get that one coming up in a couple of days. As we've got a conversation happening here at the Gulls bench right in front of us. Not quite sure what the concern is, but now the referees are going to go talk to the Bedford bench and let them know whatever topic was, how it will apply. And now we're going to go talk to the timekeepers as well. Oh, no, we're just... Oh, yeah, we're going to have a quick little chat with the timekeeper. Although the way he waved his hand there made it seem like, it's nothing for you to worry about. So, and of course, we're a little bit too far away to be able to read lips and or hear what's being said. But the second period is now underway. Johnson plays it down into the corner to Brocklehurst. Return pass broken up by Turner. And now played away by Poplinski. Turner gets the puck to Saunier. Saunier plays it over for Turner. Turner trying to avoid Breen in the corner. Goes in behind the net. Brocklehurst will play the puck up to Johnson. Johnson gives it back to Brocklehurst. And here comes the Bedford captain. Fires a shot, save made there by the goaltender Chandler Bell. Henry with a shot from the line, another save by Bell. Puck in the corner. Gregoire plays it around to the far side for Foot. Foot gets it ahead to Saunier. Over to Liver, quickly out for Turner. Turner tries a little toe drag, but the puck rolls away from him and Elaine able to come the other way. He gets a shot off, and I don't know if Bell got a piece of that with his toe or not. Now here's McQueen picking up the bouncing puck. McQueen with a shot. He puts that one off of the corner of the crossbar in the post. McQueen with a nice backhand was able to beat Bell. Now a chance for Hodder, but he puts it over the net. Sometimes as a team, you need a little bit of luck to go your way, and the Gulls get some luck there as the Bandits put one off the crossbar and then put one just over the crossbar. A couple of great chances to tie up this game against the league's leading team in pretty much every category you can name. As we had players from both teams get into the face-off circle a little bit early, so we'll do it again. There we go. McQueen gets the possession off of the draw. Ends up getting taken off the puck by Gregoire. Now a pass ahead for Hartland. Hartland coming in. He's got a man with him. Hartland gets it across, and what a goal there. Hartland to Chip. And Chip puts it into the net at 1:46 of the second period. And it is now 2-0 for the Gulls. After a great opportunity for the Bandits to tie it up, and they're not able to take advantage. Going the other way, Aaron Chip gets his first goal, second point of the tournament. And Hartland gets what ends up being the only assist on that goal. So for both Chip and Hartland, that's their second points of the game. Hartland assisting on both goals now. As Walter scored 18 seconds into the first period, and Chip scores a minute 46 into the second. McGilvery's clear ahead, goes off of Chip. Now McGilvery's got to go all the way back down into the end boards. Hartland takes him off the puck. Chip gets it out for Walters, but Walters couldn't pull the trigger on a shot, and McQueen will come back the other way. McQueen has it knocked off his stick by Gregoire. Puck played over to the far wall. Trying to get it is Hodder, but he loses control. And coming out now, here's Chip. Chip getting a step, coming in. Chip makes the move and scores! Aaron Chip gets two goals in the span of 40 seconds. And a 2-0 game is now 3-0. Aaron Chip with a pair of goals 40 seconds apart. That gives him 2 goals and 3 points on the tournament. And we're 2 minutes and 26 seconds into the first game, or the second period of the first game of the event. This time, Chip's goal is unassisted, and we're going to get the Gulls to their first power play of the game as a boarding call is going to go against, I believe it's Nathan Kidd. I'm pretty sure that was the number I saw. Yes, now I can confirm it is Nathan Kidd who gets the penalty for boarding. And he's got to be careful to not get anything else beyond that as he was talking to the referee his whole way up. So a boarding call against Chip with 2:37 gone here in the second period. And the Gulls were incredibly dangerous with the power play through the regular season. I don't have exact percentages, but I can tell you that as a team, they scored a grand total of, 33 power play goals in 33 regular season games. They also scored 3 power play goals in their 2-game series they had against the Western Hurricanes, which they swept. So this, their first power play of the provincial tournament. We'll see how that goes for them. We mentioned the Gulls beat the Western Hurricanes 2-0. The Bandits were playing in the 6-7 series. Came in as the 6th seed, but lost to the Novas in 2 straight games. So as the team that lost, but was the highest ranked losing team through the playoff round, they come in as the number 7 seed in this tournament, despite being the number 6th ranked team in the regular season. Here's Foote with the puck. Foote looking for Walters for a deflection. Couldn't quite get that to connect. The puck comes up the wall to Hartland. 1:10 left to go in the power play. Across, looking for Walters again on the back door, but the puck just hops over his stick. Now Hartland not quite able to hold it onside. He'll have to back up. Plays it over to Foote as they back up to their own blue line. Now sent ahead again for Chip. Chip gives it to Turner, who goes to Walters, back to Hartland. Return for Walters. Across to the far side, but that pass broken up by O'Leary, and he'll launch it down the ice. 44 seconds left to go in the Gulls' man advantage. Puck comes up the boards to Chip. He'll play it around, and Walters will pick up. Turns it back to Foote. Foote gives to Hartland. Hartland drops it back to Walters. Across to the far side. That pass just a little bit out of the reach of Chip. And just held onside by Walters after Gibbs tried to clear it. Gibbs now knocks it off the stick of Walters. Can't clear the zone as that's gloved down by Poplinski to Chip. Turner deflected that puck right on net. Might have been better served if he had let that puck go through to Gregoire for a one-timer. But I don't think Turner realized that Gregoire was in position for that shot. 8 seconds left to go in the penalty. 10:31 left to go here in the second period, with the Gulls leading this one by a score of 3-0. Saunier takes the draw against Alain. Saunier wins it back. Poplinski with it at the line. He'll fire it around the boards. Comes to Liver at the wall. Liver has it bounce over his stick. And we're going to get another penalty, as the referee saying that McQueen tripped up Liver and that's why he went down. So just a couple of seconds after the Bandits finish killing off their first penalty of the game, they take their second. This one going to Ryder McQueen for tripping. And like I said, I didn't have exact power play percentages, but the Gulls through the regular season averaged a power play goal per game. So you got to figure that percentage is pretty good. With the puck now is Power. He'll give it to Gregoire. Gregoire goes to Poplinski with it. Now to the front of the net. Power, his redirect ends up going way up high into the air. Power able to knock it off of a lane stick before he's able to clear. Link gets it, and he's able to fire it around the boards and down the ice. Poplinski will go back and pick up with 40 seconds gone in the penalty. Poplinski will leave the puck behind the net. Hartland will go back and get it. And now Hartland comes out on the right side of his net, working his way forward. Coming through center, in across the blue line. Takes the puck towards the left wing wall, plays it around to the right wing side. Getting to it is Turner. Turner taking it away from the boards, plays it over to Chip. Chip in front of the net, looking for Hartland, but the shot ended up going right through in the save made by Potter. Now Turner with it in the corner. Back to the line for Foot. Over for Chip. Chip comes to Hartland. Hartland with a shot. It's deflected and then blocked. Now Walters with it. He'll play it over to Chip. Back to Walters. Back to Chip. Chip sends it back to the line. Hartland back to Chip again. Chip with a shot. He scores. And that's a hat trick for Aaron Chip. Chip with the natural hat trick. Hartland will get his third assist. Foot should also get an assist on that goal. We'll wait for confirmation of that assist. But it definitely was Foot to Hartland to Chip. And then past Tucker Potter. And I don't know many goalies who could have been able to stop that shot with that speed on it from that range. As we get confirmation of Chip's goal. And confirmation of the assists as we figured they were going to be. Jacob Hartland and Logan Foot getting the assists on Aaron Chip's third goal, fourth point of the tournament. 6:23 elapsed in the second period. The time you're hearing announced by the PA announcer in-house is the time still on the clock when the goal was scored. Here comes McDonald coming in. His shot and the steered aside by Potter. Fleming gets to the puck. Now McDonald, he's bumped off of it, and Henry will gather the puck in. Uses the boards. Gets it over to Gibbs. Gibbs will take it behind the net. Trying to find a lane to clear. Gets it ahead to Henry over to Hodder. Or sorry, that was Carver over to Hodder. Who dumps it down into the goal zone. Back to pick up there is Poplinski. His lead pass for Fleming. But Link right there to help break that up. Link not able to clear the zone as Turner keeps the puck in. Turner takes it down below the goal line. Gets it to the front of the net. There's a chance for Poplinski, but the puck just rolled off his stick. Now Liber will play it back to Poplinski again. It ends up hitting a stick that was left on the ice by Fleming. And the Bedford Bandits able to intercept a pass. Cherrett nine irons it out to center. And now bringing the puck back in is Liber. Liber able to work his way through Cherrett. Couldn't get the pass to the front of the net as Link was there to knock that away. 6:35 left to go here, second period. Puck cleared out to center ice. Foot loses it to McQueen. He's able to get it back. Play it back to Turner. Turner now taking a look, working his way ahead and fighting through the check of McQueen. Cherrett comes over to help out as well. Turner tying up the puck along the wall. Referee telling them to move it. Turner finally gives it back to Roberts. Roberts being watched by Cherrett now. Turns to get the puck ahead to Liver. He'll bat it past McGilvery into the Bedford zone. Puck cleared ahead. Now McQueen not able to get the puck out. Link will, but it's right onto the stick of Roberts, who plays it to Walters near side. He'll come into the zone, try to feather a pass through. That's knocked down by McGilvery. And now Alain has the puck knocked away from him as they come through the blue line. Foot gets it ahead for Walters. Walters will come up through center, in across the blue line. Walters takes it, fires it off the side of the net. It comes to the front. Chip with a chance. And Chip nearly gets his fourth of the game, but Potter able to flash some leather and make the save. 5:32 left to go here in period number two. And the Gulls leading it by double two. That means four. I had the theme going in the two, so I had to stick with it a little longer. Alain with the puck. Can't clear the zone as Gregoire knocks that down. Back down into the corner. Breen sends it around to the far side. Now Hodder with it. He'll get it out to center for Alain. Alain in across the blue line for Brocklehurst. Brocklehurst in the corner. Out front for Hodder. There's a shot and a save made by Bell. The 10th save that Bell's made so far this afternoon. He hasn't been very busy, but when he's been called upon, he's made the saves he's had to make. And that's really all you can ask of your goaltender. He's doing what they need him to do and keeping his team comfortably in front by four into the last 5 minutes of the second period. Chip, able to get the puck out to center, gets it up for Walters. Walters tried to feed it across for Hartland. That's going to be an offside as the puck was knocked down at the blue line while the Gulls were on their way in. So we'll get a stoppage with 4:44 left to go here in the second period. A reminder, the Bandits' next game will be tonight, right after the opening ceremonies. They'll take on the Truro Bearcats, the host team of this event. For the Gulls, as the number one seed, they play their four games against the 7, 6, 5, and 4 seeds, not necessarily in that order. Their next game will also be against the Bearcats, however. It'll be the 10 a.m. game tomorrow. There's Hodder with a shot, another save made by Chandler Bell. As we mentioned earlier, all seven teams play four games each. The number one seed, as the number one seed, the advantage that they get is they play the four lowest seeds coming into the event, which theoretically should give them the advantage to get the spot that they wish for in the semifinals. Jay fires the puck around the ice. That's going to be an icing call as 4:29 will have to go here in the second period. The number two seed will play, I believe they play 3, 5, 6, and 7. 3 ends up playing 2, 4, 5, and 7, I think. There is a specific formula that works out so that the schedules are weighted to the advantage of the teams that finish higher in the regular season. So that's the... Because you're going into a round-robin tournament, there has to be some sort of an advantage for finishing at the top of the league. And it's... Because it's an incomplete round-robin, the advantage is you get the quote-unquote easier schedule. And that is the reward for finishing at the top through the first 33 games of the year. Here's Kidd with the puck now. His shot blocked by Jay. Picking up is McDonald. He'll get it ahead. To the line. Not out. Held in there by Link. Link steps in. His shot goes up over the glass and out of play. And will get it face off inside the goal zone with a deflection off of a goal stick. Bit of an echo on my voice. Just reduce the size of the logo, move it to the top right. Okay. Bit of an echo on my voice. All right, I'll turn my... Come down a little bit further there. Actually, I think I've gone too far with that. There we go. Check, check, check. And moving that logo. I will move that logo, Chava, in 3 minutes and 22 seconds at the end of the period. Not going to try and mess around with it right now. Because knowing me, I'd find a way to mess it up. So, and you notice as well, puck played ahead for Liver. Here comes Liver coming in. Liver shoots and it goes just wide. Puck comes up the wall to Gregoire. He'll play it down to Turner in the corner. Turner couldn't get the bouncing puck to settle. Link was able to get it. He played it around the far side, but the Bandits do end up clearing the puck on the second effort, and here comes a chance for Jarrett. Jarrett coming in alone. Jarrett with a shot, and getting just enough of that puck there was the goaltender Chandler Bell. Now here's Turner with it. 2:45 to go in the period. Turner coming to the net, takes the shot and scores! And it's 5-0. What a shot by Tristan Turner as he gets his first. And I think we're going to see an assist go to Ethan Saunier. We'll wait for the official word on that coming up momentarily. But it's definitely Turner's first goal, first point of the event. At 12:21 of the first or second period. And Saunier does indeed get an assist, and it turns out it is the only assist. So again, Tristan Turner from Ethan Saunier at 12:21 of the second period, making it 5-0. There's a shot, save made. Alain with the shot, that's also saved by Bell. And finally, the puck cleared away. Foot gets it to Chip. Chip not able to clear the zone, however. Now Hartland will come back and get it at the wall. He's met by Alain, but Hartland able to play it around to Roberts. Roberts takes a hit from Alain. Foot gets his stick on the puck. It ends up bouncing to where Walters can gather it in. And now Hartland, his pass bounces over the stick of Chip. Chip going after it, working against Normore. Normore will get body possession and ends up playing it up the wall, intercepted by Walters. Now the puck bouncing to the front of the net, cleared away by Breen. Jay steps in. He fires a shot. That goes wide. And up the wall it comes out to center. Walters tried to play it up to Chip, but that was a little too high for him. Now Alain with the puck. He loses it. Following up is Hodder. Hodder gets a shot away. Not much on that shot, unfortunately, for him. Chip now working along the wall against Normore. Puck ends up with Walters. And Walters, with some space, ends up flipping it ahead. Chip was in behind the defense, gets it over to Hartland. But the puck just rolls off of Hartland's stick as he took the pass just a little bit off the toe. Down to the final minute of period two. Around the boards, Breen will pick up. Breen trying to work his way out to center. He does. Gets it ahead for McQueen. McQueen has it knocked, or has a pass deflected, and it'll end up on the stick of Power. Here comes Power up the ice. Into the Bedford zone, drops it back. Shot taken there by Myra. Carter Myra, the AP, playing for the Gulls this weekend, as they are without a couple of their regulars, Ewan McDonald and Samir Knight Al-Kaib. And if I mispronounce that, I do apologize. Here's McQueen with the puck now, taking it to the outside, centering it for O'Leary. O'Leary couldn't get much of a shot away as it was deflected, and now Quay McDonald able to get it ahead to Power. Power working the outside, gets the puck to the front of the net. It's battered with a high stick, and that will bring us to the end of period number two. And after the whistle, we get some pushing and shoving. And it looks like cooler heads are going to avail. Both teams with eight shots in that second period, but the big difference, four of those eight shots for the Gulls ended up being goals. And so after 30 minutes of play, it is the Gulls 5, the Bedford Bandits 0. We're going to take a break. We'll come back, get you ready for the third period in just a few minutes. You are watching the Nova Scotia Under 15 Major Hockey League Provincial Tournament, sponsored by Coltech, here on AO Live Atlantic Hockey Online, produced by Peter Sports and Streaming Services. That's why
our silver sponsor is Andy's Fire Drive Limited. Our bronze sponsors are Motor Hunt Automotive Group, Stan Hughes Limited, Dairy Green, and Bertram Dugan. for your continued support. Thank you.
gold differential and whatnot.
Makes sense.
It's used.
I don't think there was last year.
Yeah, I don't.
Welcome back as we get ready for the start of the third period. So we did. There we go. Sorry about that, folks. Not quite sure what happened there, but at least it happened while it was just me talking and not while anything important was going on. As I was saying, we went through, we took a look at some of the tournament regulations during the intermission just to check on a couple of things and confirm that, yes, if a game does end regulation tied, it remains a tie. So I was right about that one. The other thing that we looked to check on is if there's any sort of allocation for if any game has to go to straight time due to margins of victory or whatnot. Or margins, not of victory at that point, but just goal margin at a certain point within the third period. Nothing in the regulations that I saw indicated anything, so we'll have to just sort of play it by ear. If the Gulls get a couple of goals early in this period, we'll just have to watch and see what happens. But I don't believe there is any tournament regulation that accounts for going to straight time at any point in the third period. Here's Walters getting the puck and he'll dump it in. Of course, the way the Bedford Bandits have been playing, this really hasn't felt like a 5-0 hockey game. So the Bandits do have the capability of climbing back into this one. As here comes Alain. He tried to drop the puck off for Breen, but didn't get quite enough juice on that. Now Walters will take it back down the other way, down into the corner. All the way behind the net. Walters able to play it over to Chip. Chip gets it out in front. But the pass intended for Hartland, broken up nicely by Breen. And that ends up sending the puck all the way down the ice. Poplinski back to get it in his own zone. A reminder, the next game will be scheduled for a 2 o'clock puck drop. And we will have that one just like we have every game for you. Here through Atlantic Hockey Online, AOT, or AO Live, excuse me. Chip with the puck again. Takes a bump from McGill, replays the puck down into the corner. Nobody for the Gulls there to go get it. It comes around to the near side. Pass for Brocklehurst. Brocklehurst can't get by Roberts, but he does get the puck down deep into the Gulls zone. Foot back to get it here. A minute 15 gone in the third period. Pass over to Liver. Liver goes cross ice with it for Sonier. Sonier tried to set it up for Turner. That pass missed everybody and ends up going down in across the goal line, and so we'll get an icing call against the Gulls. Gulls, one of six teams who do not have a geographical location in their name out of the 12 teams in this league. There's a little trivial fact for you. The Gulls, the Rangers, the Werewell Bombers, the Jonal Jim Cougars, the New Scotland Storm, as theirs is that's a reference to the apparel company that sponsors them. There's a shot, a save made. Gulls, Rangers, Cougars, Gulls, Rangers, Cougars, Bombers, Storm, and there's one more. And now I've been drawing a blank on it. Delayed penalty coming up against the Gulls, and as that shot gets blocked, by Jay, we're going to get a penalty, and it's going to be Jay who goes off for the tripping. 17:57 left to go here in the third period, excuse me. The Novas, that was the other one. Yeah, those six teams do not have any reference to any geographical location in their names. The other six do. One of those odd quirks of this league. McQueen deflects the puck down into the corner. Brocklehurst and Gregoire battle for it there. McQueen comes in and gets the puck, gives to Alain. Alain gives to Brocklehurst. Back to the line for Breen. Breen skating it along the blue line, fires a shot and scores! Joseph Breen on the power play gets the Bandits on the board, and it's now 5-1. Joseph Breen with his first goal, first point of the tournament, coming on the power play. So both teams now 1-for-2 with the man advantage here this afternoon. And that's a big one for the Bandits' confidence level. Possibly the start of a big comeback here. And while I was listening to them announce Breen's goal from Brocklehurst, all Aaron Chip does is get his fourth of the game and reopen the five-goal lead. Taking a pass from out behind the net, and Chip in perfect position. And it was a four-goal game again for 17 seconds before Aaron Chip got his fourth goal of the afternoon. Hartland gets his fourth assist of the game. Walters gets his second point. 2:47, the time of that goal, and while I was listening to that get announced, just to double check on the assists, the Gulls almost got another one, but a beautiful save made by Potter there. Here's O'Leary with the puck, gets it ahead for Charrett. Charrett getting a step on Jay. Charrett coming in, but by the time he was able to get the puck, he was in too deep to get a shot away. Conlon now back to the line for Henry. Henry with a shot, and the blocker save made by the goaltender Kent Chandler Bell. Now with the puck, Myra. He'll play it around to the far side for Hartland. Hartland trying to work himself free. He couldn't. Chair it with a shot. That gets blocked by Walters, and it down the ice it goes. And we're going to get a penalty against the Bandits here as Chip was hooked up trying to chase down a loose puck. And so the third power play of the game for the Gulls comes with 16:19 to go. It's going to be a hooking call against Schaefer Gibbs. And Gulls leading by five with a chance to make it a six-goal margin here with the power play. 3:41 gone in the third. Liver gets the puck to Power. Power trying to poke it in just past the foot of Potter, but Potter able to stay stretched out enough that the puck was forced wide. Poplinski behind his own net leaves the puck for Liver. Liver now working his way ahead, goes to flip it out. It goes off of Johnson, ends up on the stick of Power. Now Saunier with it far side. He can't find an entry lane, but does get the puck to Poplinski, who does bring the puck into the zone. Cross ice pass broken up by Johnson and cleared down the ice. 1:18 to go in the power play. Foot back to pick up. He's going to wait for his team to get organized for the breakout. Foot feeds it to Turner. Turner gets it ahead across ice for Hartland in across the blue line. Hartland coming towards the net, throws it in front, they score! I don't think that puck got all the way to another goal. I think it was Hartland who, trying to get it to the front of the net, ended up scoring. And it's the second power play goal of the game for the Gulls as they go up by 6. So it's now 7-1. And the Gulls were still short a player, so they had to get themselves organized. There we go. If it is Hartland's goal, which we assume it is, that's Hartland's first goal, fifth point of the tournament. And now that's going to be an offside against the Gulls as Foot had gone into the zone. The puck didn't quite go in with him, and then it followed him in, so that is an offside. Just under 5 minutes gone here in period number three. The time of the goal, 5:41 on the power play. Hartland's first goal, fifth point. And yes, this is the first game of the tournament, and he's got 5 points in this tournament already. Now leading the tournament in scoring. Chip with 4 points, all of them goals. Fleming trying to work the puck through. He couldn't. Link trying to get away from Roberts, but Roberts does enough to keep the puck. Now Brocklehurst will pick it up, and he'll work his way into the goal zone. Brocklehurst skates through the check of Foot, takes a bump from Fleming. Now Foot ties up Brocklehurst along the end boards. Foot wins the puck, plays it up the wall. It's held in there by Gibbs, who plays it down to Brocklehurst. Brocklehurst behind the net, looking for somebody to pass to. Didn't have anybody. Ends up playing it all the way out to center. Henry gets it across to Gibbs. Gibbs fires a shot right on, and that's steered aside by Bell. Picking up the puck there is Foot. He gets it ahead to Amaro. Amaro tried to get a pass through to McDonald. Conlin knocked that down. Now McDonald back on the puck. He coughs it up to McLean. McLean can't get it shot away. Takes the puck back to the blue line. Now gives it to Gibbs. Gibbs steps in. He fires a shot off the post. And the Gulls have had a couple of posts work their way. They've had another chance by the Bandits go just wide. This could be a 7-4 hockey game right now. And if the Bandits had gotten one or two of those other ones to go in, the complexion of this game completely different. There's Gibbs with a shot and a kick save made by Bell. Now bringing the puck out to center ice is Amaro. He's got Fleming coming up with him. Amaro working down the left wing, or right wing, excuse me, fires a shot. The save made by Potter. As we reach 7 minutes gone in the third period. Gibbs out from behind his net, plays it over to Cherrett. Cherrett's pass a little bit too hot to handle for McLean. Poklinski will send it back down into the Bandit zone. Potter settles it there for Breen. Green's pass goes off the stick of Henry. Poklinski will send it back deep. Now picked up by Turner. He'll take it behind the net. Turner goes back to the line for Gregoire. His shot, and that goes into the end boards. McLean trying to get it past Poklinski. Liver in there as well. Liver works it back down to the end boards. Turner doesn't quite get to it before Henry does. Henry able to keep the puck. Now he'll play it ahead for Cherrett. Cherrett working his way up the left wing. Gets the puck through. There's a chance for McQueen and a nice save made by Bell. And he will hold on for the faceoff with 12-12 left to go here in period number three. Faceoff between Turner and McQueen. Turner wins it down to the corner. Breakout pass intercepted by O'Leary. O'Leary trying to get him to the front of the net for McQueen. That's broken up. And Turner will carry it ahead. He's got Liver and Saunier with him. Turner working down the left wing into the corner. Takes it behind the net, out into the right side corner. Now back to the line. That pass intended for Myra. It hops, or it goes just underneath his stick, as I think he was setting up for it to come up on him a bit. Now Walters with the puck. Will bring it right back in again. Gets it to Liver. Liver gets a shot away, but that goes wide as Breen was forcing Liver to the outside. Now the puck gets to the line, held in by Jay. He'll play it around the boards. Normore will get to it for the Bandits in the corner. His pass ends up on the stick of Jay of the Gulls. There's a shot, save, rebound. Walter's shot gets blocked by Normore. Now Chip in the corner gets it out in front, but it ends up getting past Hartland and then all the way past everybody down the length of the ice. 11-11 left to go, third period. Jay ahead to Walters. Walters gets it up to Hartland. Hartland trying to get it back through for Walters. That's broken up by McGilvery. And the Bandits look to work their way out. Brocklehurst loses the puck to Hartland, who ends up playing it back to Foote. Ahead for Chip. Across to Hartland. Here comes Hartland coming in. Hartland drop pass for Walters. Walters with a backhand shot and the save made by Potter. Now Robert sends it down into the corner. Picked up there by McGilvery. He ends up overskating the puck. Walters couldn't get it to sit. Link will get it around the wall for Alain. And Alain works it out to center. He gets stood up by Foote. That allows Chip to go back and pick up the puck. Chip gets it ahead. Now Walters with it. Working against Link. Walters dumps it in deep. Gibbs will go back and pick up with 10:14 to go in the third period. Gibbs takes it back behind the net again. Now circles the other way, trying to get away from Fleming. Gets the pass ahead. That's out of the reach of Alain. Now Foote going the other way with it. Fleming will pick up. He's got power with him. Fleming comes in, shoots, and puts... He did score! I wasn't sure, but the referee right there indicated that the puck did indeed go in. So Sam Fleming gets the goal that makes it 8-1. And for Fleming, that's his first goal, first point of the tournament. Power and Jay get the assists on that goal. So once again, Sam Fleming, first goal, first point, assisted by Spencer Power and Donovan Jay at 10:06 of period number three. Gibbs plays it to the near side for Henry. Henry gets it ahead to Conlon. Conlon plays it over. There's a shot from, that was McLean, I do believe. No, that was Kidd. My apologies. It was 18, not 10. Green with the puck now. There's a shot. Another save made by Bell, and he'll hang on for a faceoff with 8:57 left to go here in the third period. So I guess this answers the question of whether or not there would be running time, as we've reached a 7-goal margin and we still have the clock stopping. So I can't imagine that they would make an allowance at 8 or 9, but not at 7. So, and I'm not saying that to be disrespectful to the Bandits. I'm saying it that just to confirm the ruling. Here's Liver with the puck. Is it off the end boards to Turner. Turner fans on a shot, is able to maintain control, plays it back to Jay. Jay with a shot, he scores. Donovan Jay will get his second point, and that will make it 9-1 with 8:26 left. I think Potter was screened on that shot. Can't say it with absolute certainty, but it looked like the way Potter reacted, that he did not actually see that one coming in. There's McGilvery with the puck now. They'll play it to Link. Link's pass goes through the feet of McQueen. So they give credit on the goal to Evan Liver. So that's Liver's first goal, first point of the tournament, assisted by Donovan Jay and Tristan Turner. So obviously the puck was redirected. May not have been screened, but was redirected, according to our officials. And so therefore, it is Liver's first goal, first point of the tournament. From Jay and Turner at 11:34. Battle for the puck. It's played out to center. Foot pokes at it, but now Link comes through. Link coming in with a chance, and the puck just rolls off his stick. Bell maybe with a little bit of a poke check there to help clear it away. Now McQueen back to get it. McQueen, his pass is deflected. Ends up on the stick of Gibbs. He'll carry it ahead. In across the blue line, fires a shot. But just as he took the shot, the whistle blew for the offside, and good non-reaction by everybody on that shot as well. Sometimes you see it where a guy takes a shot, not realizing it's an offside. The whistle blows as he touches the puck for the shot, and the team getting shot on reacts like the puck is loose. Cleared away. Nice play there by Hodder. As Hodder saves a goal right there. Now Hodder gets the puck, works his way back up the other way. Gets it to the front of the net. That's batted aside by Bell. Now Walters gets it. He plays it over to Hartland, across to the near side for Chip. And Chip goes back across to Hartland, over for Walters. But that pass just off the toe of his stick. And the Bandits pick up and come the other way. Breen will poke it down towards the corner, goes chasing after it, gets to it himself, tries to give it to Brocklehurst. That's broken up by Walters. Now the puck knocked down by Hodder. He plays it over to the near side boards. Alain will send it into the corner. Brocklehurst picks up there, centers it for Normore. Normore has that pass go through his feet. He's able to recover, get a backhand shot, but it's blocked. Now the puck comes to the line. Breen able to hold it onside. Breen with the shot, and it's gloved down by the goaltender Bell, and he'll hang on for a faceoff with 6:16 to go here in the first. Don't forget our next game coming up in just a few minutes. Well, the warm-up will start as soon as this game is over. And that is the Novas and the New Scotland Storm. We'll start the stream at 2 o'clock, which is the time that the game is scheduled to start. And it looks like we'll be pretty close to dead on time. I assume they're going to do the warm-ups on quote-unquote dirty ice. They won't bother to flood until after the warm-ups. Which, as that puck gets past Myra and out to center, Jay back to pick up. Jay plays it ahead. Breen will gather it in just inside the Bedford blue line. Take it all the way back down below his own goal line. And work his way ahead. Breen through center, in across the blue line, but that gets called an offside, and so we'll get another stoppage with 5:35 left to go here in the third. 9-1 the score, and oh, it is 9-1, I apologize. There we go. 9-1 the score in favor of the Gulls. Like I said earlier, if there's a discrepancy between the score and what we know to be the score on the screen and what we know to be the actual score, it's just that I haven't hit a button yet. As the Bandits, a little bit frustrated, they will take the initial penalty for the hit on Turner. Sonier may get something for coming in retaliatory as well. Charrett is the one who delivered the initial hit. So Charrett gets two for boarding and two for roughing. Sonia gets two for roughing. So the extra two minutes to go on the board against the Bandits. So there should be another guy to go over there and serve the extra two. We have 5:23 left to go here in the third. Yeah, thank you. that's what the referee is indicating right now. You need a guy from the ice to... And it's going to be Johnson who goes over to serve the extra two. So it's going to be, again, Cherrett for boarding and for roughing. Saunier just for roughing. Both of those penalties coming at 14:37. So it's the fourth power play of the game for the Gulls. They are 2-for-3 to this point. And there's 1:48 left to go with the man advantage. As we get confirmation of all those penalties, puck played up the boards to Liver. Liver's pass broken up by McGilvery. He can't clear the zone, however, as Poplinski knocks it down. Poplinski plays it around. Turner will pick up. Skate the puck up to the line. Play it across to Poplinski near side. Across for Gregoire. Gregoire goes to play it back to the point, but ends up splitting the two defensemen. Turner back with the puck. And he'll start to work it ahead. Here comes Turner in across the line. Turner coming in, gets it off the post. As the Gulls power play almost strikes for a third time. Now pass across for Fleming, but it was just a little bit beyond his reach. He had to stretch out and just slowed the puck down, but didn't actually get it under control. Myra plays it down into the corner for Liver. Liver's pass just beyond the reach of McDonald, and it ends up going all the way down the ice. Jay will go back and pick up. We have 38 seconds left in the power play. Myra has trouble getting the puck out of his feet. McQueen brings it in. Now he'll take it back and send it back down into the goal zone. Playing off a few more seconds. Jay with the puck. 17 seconds left in the power play. Now Jay comes out from behind his net. Pass up for Power. Power met immediately by Gibbs. And they battle for the puck directly below us here in our perch high above the Rath Eastland Community Center and Credit Union Arena. There's a shot from Jay and he scores. This will not be a power play goal as it came like tenths of a second after the penalty had expired. But it will be a goal for Donovan Jay, his third point. And that one wasn't deflected, so it'll definitely be his goal. And that makes it 10-1 for the Gulls. .323 to go here, third period. There we go. I was going to say. So Donovan Jay gets his first goal, third point of the tournament, unassisted at 16:37. Again, the time that they are announcing here in the building is the time that appears on the clock. The time that I'm using is the elapsed time in the period in question, which is how you see goals reported at most other levels, which is why I'm doing it that way. Here's Walters with the puck now. He lost it, but it's played out to center, then brought back in by Roberts, and that'll be an offside with 2:50 left to go. Our next game, the second-seeded New Scotland Storm against the sixth-seeded Novas. Novas finished the regular season in seventh, but defeated the Bandits in their playoff series, so they come in as the sixth seed in the tournament. Bandits as the seventh seed, as the one team that did not win their playoff series that made it. Here's Myra with the puck. He plays it ahead. Chip now able to get it out to center. He's got Walters with him. They come up 2-on-1, 3-on-1 as they're being joined by Hartland. Walters Chip elects to shoot, and Potter makes the save with 2:21 to go. That line has been absolute dynamite here this afternoon. That line responsible for 5 of the 10 goals. Chip with 4 goals. Hartland with a goal and 4 assists. Oh, sorry, that line has been responsible for 6 goals. Chip with 4 goals and an assist. Hartland with a goal and 4 assists. Walters with a goal and an assist. As they have controlled this game. Now we're going to get another penalty. And it's going to be a kneeing penalty against Kidd. And I believe that is a 4-minute penalty. It is indeed. So the Gulls will be on the power play for the rest of this game unless they score twice in the last minute and 56 seconds. And Power with the puck, gets it to the front of the net. McDonald deflects it, and it ends up going underneath Tucker Potter, and Potter able to make the save. Hangs on for a faceoff with 1:48 left. To be fair to the Gulls, the guys they've got out there on the power play right now are not the guys who've been the big scorers in this game. So it's not an indication that they're, you know, trying to run things up or anything like that, but they are, the players who are out there are continuing to play hard, which is all you can really ask of guys. You can't ask them to not play the game. But it's not like, you know, you've got the guys out there who have 5 points out there trying to get a 6th. Gregoire with the puck. Takes it down into the corner. Now plays it back up. Amaro gives to Jay. Jay plays it down to the corner for Power. Power takes it behind the net. Being watched by Link. Power sends it back down into the corner for Quay McDonald. McDonald trying to get away from Link. Power comes over to help out. Power will get the puck as we're into the final minute. There's a shot that goes wide. Puck comes up the wall to Jay. He plays it down. It hops past Amaro. Power now in behind the net. Gets it back out to Jay. Down to Power. Centered for McDonald. McDonald's shot is steered away. Now back on the stick of Power. Power with the shot. That's blocked by McGilvery. Bouncing puck. Trying to find it in his feet was O'Leary. He couldn't. But Link did, and Link fires it down the ice. 28 seconds left to go. Jay with the puck below his own goal line. Starts to work his way out. Coming up the ice slowly. 17 seconds left. Plays it ahead for Liver. Liver will send it off the end boards. It bounces right to Potter, and so he'll cover up and hang on under 12 seconds remaining. So we'll be off air for approximately 27, 28 minutes. And then we'll be back on for the start of our next game. As the puck is played with a high stick, so we get another stoppage. 2:07 left to go in the power play for the Gulls. Not that that really has impact on how this game is going to turn out. Gulls with the 10-1 lead right now will open the tournament with an emphatic victory. Almost got their 11th. And that will do it for the opening game here at the 2023 Nova Scotia Under 15 Major Hockey League Championship Tournament. We'll stick around for the presentation of the players of the game. So we'll stick around for the handshakes and then the presentation of the players of the game, and then we'll sign off until the next game, which, again, it'll be about 27 minutes. Okay, there won't be handshakes. We'll just go to the presentation of the players of the game. For the Gulls, you've got two different guys who had a five-point game. You could pick either one of those two or just about anybody else on the Gulls. For the Bandits, I thought Alex Alain had a good game. Joseph Breen scored the goal. Max Brocklehurst had the assist on the goal. So a few different guys we could choose from. Aaron Chip gets player of the game for the Gulls, and like I said, he was one of the guys who had a five-point game, so hard to argue against that logic. Ben Henry is player of the game for the Bandits. Good choice there. I thought he played well for them. And so that is going to do it for this one. We'll be back with you in 27 minutes for the Novas and the New Scotland Storm. Until then, on behalf of my awesome cameraman, Lucas, this is Michael Petter saying, may your skates always be sharp, may your shots always hit the top shelf. Final score, once again, the Gulls with a 10-1 emphatic victory to start off the 2023 Nova Scotia Under-15 Major Hockey League Championship Tournament. Thanks so much for watching. We'll be back with you in 27 minutes.